Hi everybody, so today is a day I had this book on the order for a couple of months now, so it came today, so I rushed down and picked it up. You probably know already what book it is. I've had it on my title, but anyways, this is the new Måndalen. It's Maria Rolles new book. So I just put that package away and there. Oh look at it. It's so beautiful. I really love the colors of this cover. So Måndalen by Maria Rolle. Here she tells us a little bit about what inspires her and how she made the book. So let's have a flip through. I just had to have some, or have a cup of coffee next to me. So there, yeah, it, look at this light turquoise paper. Måndalen, a coloring book illustrated by Maria Trolle. To my family. So here it tells us who the publisher is, and this is the title page. So this book belongs to my bloody camera is having a pulse. Let me see if I can zoom in. That probably will help it. Have to move my coffee to the other side. So this is the title page, and let's open it up. Maybe I zoomed a little bit too much in. Maybe a little bit out again. There. There we can see both pages. Oh look, so we have a cute little mice lying in its nest, and with bluebells and flowers around. Oh, and it's beautiful. Stag. So Måndal means moon valley. So beautiful forest fairy, or just a girl. Beautiful girl again with a moon in her forehead. We have a little kitten underneath, some leaves and stuff, and here we got one of those small ghosts that Maria sometimes put in her paintings, or her, not paintings, but her illustration. So here we have this little girl again walking on a branch with a, some kind of deer underneath. I'll try to flip a little bit fast so it doesn't, so that this video isn't to be crazy long. That is, if I can. Now this is a beautiful full page with a black background. Again we see the same girl and two other girls here, and hidden inside here we have a lot of animals. So there is a squirrel there, and we have a butterfly or a moth down there. We have a little mouse, and up here we actually have a peacock. So this can be a beautiful, beautiful page as well. Maybe I should zoom a little bit more out. There, can we see all the whole page? Hopefully. Oh, and we have a princess with all her butterflies. Bird in a nest. Another girl with bird. Oh, this is a fairy actually. Oh, and look at this girl. She is like a deer. Girl, I love her. Beautiful. Oh, I'm so excited now. I love Maria Rolle. She's one of my favorite. So here we have this princess again, but now she is covered with acorns and leaves. So can change color her like in full colors. That would be beautiful. Again, we have a couple of deers here, a female and a male. They have nice tongue version. A little animal or creature lying or standing there. Look at him. And this looks like to be some kind of lilies. Beautiful water. Very water creature. And also we have a parrot up there, or maybe a parakeet of some kind. Kitten, girl looking at one bird, and we have several birds around on this page. A girl covered in birds. Ooh, and a little dragon. Oh my god, isn't he cute? Up in the teddy. Ooh. And scenes like this I just adore. We have zoom in again. You can see it's teddy houses with a bird, and we have a mouse, and there we have a little gnome girl. I don't know if you can see her because she is so tiny. Look at her. There she is sitting on the teddy trunk. And the other side, yeah, squirrel, what looks to be like a mother and a baby underneath a big mushroom. Again, another night time. So I guess that most of these images is supposed to be during the night, because it's called Moon Valley. So and then the moon is up at night. Look at all those tulips. Oh, they will be so much fun to color. This girl is so cute. More teddy houses and a little ghost up there, and then we have what looks like to be some kind of Easter lilies. A double page spread about the palace and teddy houses and small gnomes. They're so cute. He's fixing this little mouse's tail. So maybe this is some kind of a small animal hospital or something. Another house with a lot of flowers. A little house inside there. Underneath all these flowers as well. Ooh, and another teddy houses. Again, a little girl sitting there. And then this funky looking thing. And we have this big chicken holding on to a what looks to be like a cottage and some water and a kitty with flowers and a little village in. Again, water down here. Oof, this image is beautiful. Oh my god, do we have this little or a dragon again? Look, it's so cute. And my camera. Having a pulse there, hopefully. Then we have a castle in the background and some mountains and or some hills. Ooh, here we have a lady with looks like to be kind of mother nature. We have a cat and a peacock, looks like to be. We got a fox and lots of fellows and all. We have a castle we can color. Another deer and a village and a duck pond thing. That little cottage or that little moon valley. Here we have fellows with girls in them. So I think that they are some kind of double fairies. Oh, look at this beautiful little fairy. So we have some beautiful flowers here, and then we look at that face. I mean, she is so cute. If my camera can focus, come on camera, there. It did have it there. Look, she is so cute, and she's holding onto a little bee, comforting that or cuddling a bee. Beautiful. Again, a bee and I rabbit, some kind of hanging lilies, and some birds. Here we have a female and a male fairy, or maybe she is a princess because she has a tiara on her. Hopefully you can see that. Some kind of a ball hanging down from a pheromone or something. Maybe, and then a fairy on top. So I guess that this is some kind of a fairy house. Again, this fairy lives inside a little or this flower. I love that she has so many flower fairies. Another one of those gnome girls or something, taking care of the flowers in the forest or in the valley. So here we have two small fairies as well, and a fat bee. These flowers maybe looks like poppies. Yeah, I think so. So we have a mouse, or a mouse, I mean, and a butterfly. And again, fairy houses hanging down, and two fairies sitting there gossiping probably. Ooh, this reminds me of Rapunzel, because this is a gorgeous girl, but all of this that the frame work looks like to be her bride. So and on the other side we have another girl sitting inside a flower. So nice, more flowers and a little kitten. Flowers. Now I love to color flowers, and maybe that is what why I like Aria's book so much. So we have something looking like the Loch Ness Monster, swimming around. Actually, we have one of those here in Norway as well, just not as famous as the one in Loch Ness. And they cast us along on top of that hill. And here we have another of this sea monster with boats on top and everything. This will be fun to color. Oh, and now we ended up under the water. We have a octopus and some what maybe these are squids, because their heads are kind of shaped differently. Don't really know. Another girl's face. Again, under a water castle, and a mermaid actually. Some jellyfish and fish. And there we have a mermaid princess with a gorgeous tiara. Oh, I love the variety in this book. Such a cute little girl. Like a flower fairy with a flower on her head. Another one, another girl in the valley. Ooh, and maybe I have more with black backgrounds. I really love to color them as well. They just, I think they are so nice when I just want something nice and easy and chill to color, and don't have to think about the background really. So we have a girl and a couple of birds, and of course more flowers. Here we have a little girl holding on to a little bee, sitting next to a little mouse. Flowers and leaves, of course. There we have a image that is both up and underwater as well. Frog and that little fairy or a little girl. And underneath the water is what we, where we see the fish and under water plants. Oh my god, this is awesome. There we have this little girl, and she's handed down a key. And we have this big dragon fellow there, why the what looks to be like a frog or a toad is watching her. This is an awesome page as well. A little girl playing her lute while the little ghost is listening. Another little bird. And here she is, I guess, singing good night songs to all these small, I don't know what they are, ghost spots? Or some what we call goose buds, actually. I mean, sub-padding time. But since we have ghosts in this book, so maybe this is where they come from. They are being hatched in the bushes. And we have a beautiful rabbit again, little girl, and a little mouse down there. No, that mouse is very tiny, so it's kind of hard to look or see it from a distance. But another beautiful page. And here we have the little girl again with clothes in her head and a little ghost flying around. Oh, look at that snail. Has a kind of a different kind of house than what we are used to see. No, I love things like this. And of course a girl on some mushrooms, and then we have something down there. I don't quite know what that thing is. Look at it, that little thing. Looks some kind of pea. Mice and mushrooms. Full page. More of those. Oh, we had two fairies and maybe two children there. Little girl flying or riding her bird. Then we have that little thing again, that little bird. Has he been on the other pages as well? And I just haven't seen him. Look. Oh, come on, camera. Ugh. Okay, it doesn't want to focus there. But we have that nice girl, and here we have quite a big, what looks to be like a deer, looking down at this little this forest fairy. And here we have the whole family together. So we have a little gnome, and we have this beautiful girl with the antlers. We have a forest, what we call Nisse. It's some kind of gnome, I guess. We have fairies. This is another Nisse, one of those gnomes. And we have the girl and a little fairy. The fox with a whole family gathering. You could ideally make up a full story to all of Maria's images. Here we have a double page again. So this is a big fox, so that they have decorated and stuff, and hung up some lights in the trees, and they are having a party with good food, and she is playing a lute, and he has a fiddle, so I guess that they have good music, and of course a good drink as well. I love the how intricate some of these pages are. Oh my god, and this one, look at those small dragons. Again, dragons are just so cute. Let me see. Camera. Come on, camera. There. Maybe it did have it. There. And we have another egg there. So maybe one more is going to hatch. So we have a girl riding her snail, or standing on top of it and pointing where to go. Ooh, and another double page. Lots of gnomes. Yeah, and a big deer, of course, and butterflies and everything. Beautiful. There we have a index page over all the flowers. that is in this book. So on page one, we have Ormbunksbäxter. So we got the Swedish name, or I got the Swedish name and the Latin name. So that we, if you want to Google what or how they look like, you can just type that Latin name on Google and then find out how, what that looks like. And we have a index over all the animals as well. So page one doesn't have any specific animals, but page two has a forest mice, also a apodemus. So so she gives you all the animals and insects, both butterflies and other things. Going on this page now, I really enjoy this. I'm actually learning things from her books. You can test your pens or pencils or puzzles on this page. And this is the last page. And we are closing it up again. So this is now out in Scandinavia at least. And I'm sure that it will get to the rest of the world eventually. So that was a hip through of Mario Tøndalers new book, Måndalen, which is Moon Valley. I even love the cover. This is gorgeous. So yeah, I just wanted to show all of you this new book. Thank you everybody so much for watching. Until next time, stay safe, take care, and I love you all. Bye.